Hello and welcome. Today, we'll be taking a look at how to configure the Email Statements feature in Tabs 3 Billing. We'll start by taking a look at the one-time setup items in the following areas. Configure how emails will be sent in Customization, format how the email will look using email templates, and configure clients to receive email statements in Client Information. Then, we'll cover how to generate and email a statement to those clients. Let's start by setting up your outgoing email configuration settings. From the Quick Launch, search for and select Customization. On the Main tab, you'll see that the Email Statements method determines how emails will be sent. When Outlook is selected, Tabs 3 Billing will use the workstation's current Outlook profile to send email statements. Since most users have Outlook installed, we'll leave Outlook selected. When SMTP is selected, an outgoing email configuration window in System Configuration stores the required settings. Tabs 3 Billing can then use that SMTP server to send email statements. To learn more about which setting will better suit your needs, check out Knowledge Base article R11409, Comparing Outlook versus SMTP for Email Statements. Next, let's format how the emails will look. In the Quick Launch, search for and select Email Templates. When opening email templates for the first time, you'll need to specify a default from name and from address for your emails. An email template is used to determine the formatting and content of the email message used when sending an attached PDF of the statement. Tabs 3 Billing gives you the option to use the same template for all of your clients or create different templates to fit your firm's needs. By using variables and rich text formatting in the template, you can include a personalized subject and body for each email without composing each email individually. Let's modify one of the existing templates from the Email Template Lookup. The Email Identification section allows you to assign a from name, from address, and reply to address to your emails. Note that when using SMTP, you may want to enter a BCC address to retain a copy of sent emails. When using Outlook, a copy of each email is saved in the active Outlook Profile Sent Items folder automatically. The email message is comprised of a subject and body field. Variables can be used to populate the email with information from the statement or the client file. For example, adding a sentence that includes the balance due variable will populate the client's current balance due when the email is sent. When using a credit card processor like Tabs 3 Pay, you can include payment and trust deposit links, making it easy for a client to pay online. In this case, the online payment button variable is already included in the template, but it can always be added to any template by using the variable list. Once the template looks the way you want, save the changes. Now that your template is defined, you'll need to configure your clients to receive email statements. From the clients list, select the client that you want to configure. Then, select the Billing Preferences tab. In Statement Delivery Options, click the Edit button. In the Bill To record, select the Email Statement checkbox. You can clear the Mail Statement checkbox if you don't need to print a paper copy for this client. In the Email Delivery options, the email address shown on the Address tab for this matter will be displayed, and you can select an email template from the list. Click OK to save the client. If you need to change multiple clients to use these options, you can also use the Change Client Options feature to change this setting as a batch. Now, your matters are set up to receive email statements. When ready, search for and select Generate Statements from the Quick Launch. When previewing final statements, a red and gray border will denote clients who are set up to only receive an email statement. Once your statements have been finalized and updated, you're ready to move over to the Email Statements window. Here, you can preview what your outgoing emails will look like and make edits if needed. Additionally, you can open and review the attached PDF invoice. Mark any of the invoices that you're ready to send as reviewed. You can send all reviewed statements at the same time using the Send Reviewed button. You can track which statements have been emailed using the Email Statements report, and can even drill down to a copy of the PDF file that was sent to your client. And that's all it takes. Thanks for watching. See you next time.